All right, so I'm going to go into the store in Nico, and I kind of want to show you what I do to make that happen. So, just to kind of tell you ahead of time before I do it, I still am not at the point where I want her interacting with people. So that's going to come later in her progression. What I want for when I go in here, I just want to make sure when she goes in, she feels that I'm advocating for her and that she's protected and doesn't have to do any interactions that she doesn't want to do. So if you just want to follow, something to take note of, if I see somebody fixating on her, I don't make eye contact with them, I don't engage in conversation, I typically will just like go away and take her away. And then I'm going to do something we call the step back recall in there, meaning if I see her fixate, I'm going to step away here, call her to me, and then once she's there, good girl, and then we proceed. So you just kind of want to follow me. I don't know if this will be action packed or boring or what, but we'll head in there. Okay, so I kind of want to talk about what happened right here. So as we're approaching the front of the store, sometimes I like to put the dog in a down stay to let them process cars driving by and the people and the shopping carts and all that stuff. Now, what she did when I tried to put her in a down is she wanted to curl into this corner right here. That way she's kind of protected, so she'll feel less vulnerable. At this point in the training, I want her to get past that. So if I ask her to down right here, if she comes into here, I'm actually going to make her do it again until she does it the way I want. And then when I do that, you're going to see a lot of stress. So you're going to see panting, you're going to see some shaking, like tongue flicks, yawning, her eyes are going to be blinking. Come on, girl. Nico, down. Now if she does, so she tried to go down there, down. Good girl. Alright, so she went down there okay, but it did take like handler information for me. So I, you know, blocked her with the leash. Had she been given the choice, she would have totally just went all the way back into the corner and did it. So that's something to take note of. You can help your dog learn how to process stresses and fears and anxieties if you put them out in the open just a little bit more. So a little handling technique that I like to do, if I'm walking towards somebody, I'll actually kind of walk towards them a little bit and then last 5 or 10 feet they're away. And what that does, it helps me direct the dog away. So I'll create a little space by moving over and then come away and have her follow me. So once we get up here where we're passing people, I want you to watch what that looks like when I do it. Right down there on the roof. All right, so hopefully that's kind of a good demonstration to help you understand kind of how to redirect her in public in case she fixates, and she's been an angel, so I kind of had to dramatize it a little bit, but anyway, that's what we're looking to do in public.